Dawn Till Dusk, A Portrait of Bolton by Oliver James Lomax.
Coming up over the road towards Kinder Scout, the egg of the morning sun breaks itself into a singing bowl, and a new daylight ebbs and flows all along the lifeline of the crawl, glistening on the mother tongue and shines down on our day, ancient yet young.
Over 800 years we have been carried away with her golden song.
So come all ye.
Or come all ye.
Or come ye all.
Through the tall.
Turn back to look where we have come from, for a camera obscura like a pinhole sun.
And the town turned upside down in the anatomy of time, where a steeplejack could ladder your spine, and the doorsteps are taken to a brilliant white with a donkey stone, and become a slowly developing photograph of every housewife they have known, who were cooking the books for the window cleaning money, and somehow made the breadline taste like honey, and are now just ghosts spilling out of the Theatre Royal matinee, a blurdom moving at bovine pace, shifting in ways only a river would know, coagulate into a fine mist and make a fist that opens like a ledger, uncloses its collective hand in bloom and reaches out to touch the public house television set and laid to rest, reads the braille of static on the screen like the last spray of a dying ocean that lands on our lips, their burial kissed.
And what dreams tonight of Bolton Pittman for you, Walt Whitman.
When asked why, you should be so taken with those Bolton folks. They're not famous in England at all.
This was his reply. Well, I've had my belly full of famous people. Thank God they're just nobody at all. Like all people who are worthwhile.
Because good can always see good and look it straight in the eye. And we all have to live under the same sky, and in 100 years' time, we'll still walk up to the pike raw with love, like a castle in heaven when there is a low fog, a shadow cast over a breathing lung in the blanket bog, a congregation of truant hearts dreaming of wilderness, a human church that can never trespass, an exodus for the working week that can never last.
And when the curfew of the sun meets the nodding moon, and the dying lamp brings us home too soon.
The stars blink at us as they appear through the dusk. We talk easy of tomorrow and the sleep of the just.
And time, at ye old man and scythe, never calls last orders on the echoes of life.
1,200 years of man before us, proud in the prequel. Some might stay local, some might stay equal. And I'll sup up sunshine before the new world retrieves me. But I'm telling thee, I'm telling thee, I'm telling thee. I just want to taste my ghost before it leaves me.
So come all ye.
Or come all ye.
Or come ye all.
Through the toll to this modern beautiful town for a spotlight on a theatre in the round.
A new mass observation of its conservation.
As the chimneys stand silent and hold their breath.
And look down on the legacy that they have left.
A town rich in its diversity and its humility. Never worrying about how things will fit, Bolton just gets on with it. And marrying the old with the new keeps us travelling along with you in the libraries and galleries new generations see. The history of the town and will shape what it will be. Where the viaduct stands like a stillborn god, the blue brick ghost of the canal it once held above, and the market with its theatre of light, plays a narrative through the town at night, and each new morning when this open mouth of land is yawning. The nodding trees bow to the rhythm of the day, and the dual carriageway daffodils roar at the heavens in their delicate way. The high and humming telephone wires hamstring a perfect sky, but act as a seat from which a parliament of birds can fly. And the question is lit, and the morning ovens are lit, and there is bread and school, and the children flock after a single football and score a goal 100 years ago.
And the bright day burns on.
For rich, poor, young and old.
From Winter Hill to Moses Gate.
This town does not discriminate.
A and when the long day closes, as the last sunlight dances on the meeting rivers and runs a stitch through this threadbare hour, a woman is knitting high in the pigeon tower, watching the sun over Enswistle Reservoir fall away, with only the dream of tomorrow, and that wanderers win aware.